We are excited to be bringing you the 2022 Real Estate Forecast. My name is Lane.
And I'm Scott Sacken. Welcome to the show today.
And we're going to be getting into four different things for our forecast for 2022. We're going to be talking about interest rates for mortgages. We're talking about home prices. We're going to be talking about inventory and buyer demand. So let's start quickly with interest rates. We did a whole video on it last week, so we're not going to go into too much detail. So definitely look for that video. But you want to jump in?
Absolutely. Right now, our interest rates are hovering in the low threes. And if you'll check our predictions as well as the predictions of the gurus out there, we're thinking high threes to low fours for 1 year from today.
Yeah, exactly. So you have Fannie and Freddie thinking 3.3, 3.5. You have National Association of Realtors thinking 3.5. And then the Mortgage Bankers Association thinking 4. We are closer on the Mortgage Bankers Association side, I think, of closer to 4%.
Yeah, if you check that video, Lane and my predictions were both a little bit over 4. We'll see how it plays out.
So let's talk about prices.
Absolutely. That's the magic question that we get asked almost every day. Are prices going to crash this year? Is there going to be a decrease? Well, crash is a giant word that has so much negativity to it. We can't find any evidence or resources out there that say there's going to be any decrease next year.
You know what was crazy? Over the last 12 months, we had about 20% appreciation. I know that number sounds crazy, but let's get into exactly where we got that from.
Absolutely.
So let's do the math. December of 2020, the median sales price for a single family detached home in Orange County was $955,000. December 2021, so right now we're about 2 weeks away from it ending, but $1,150,000 is the average sales price for a single family detached home in Orange County, and that's 20.4%. increase over that 12-month span.
And that's absolutely crazy.
It's unheard of. Do we think that there's going to be 20% appreciation over the next 12 months?
Absolutely not. We don't feel that way at all. And let's dive into some stats. Again, we always look to our resources to kind of frame the dialogue. And then Lane and I like to weigh in from our perspective, being what we call boots on the ground every day. We look at Fannie Mae's prediction is 7.4% increase for 2022. Freddie Mac, 7%, Lane. And then the Mortgage Bankers Association, a bit more conservative at 5.1% increase. And real quick, that translates based on the prices Lane just gave us to an increase in equity of from $58,600 to about $85,000 on those two rates.
On average between the two, which is still a very healthy appreciation if you think about it historically, because 5 years ago, we'd be looking at 4 to 6% appreciation probably over the course of 12 months, and we think that that was a pretty good number. So if we're still thinking 5 to close to 8% conservatively, that's pretty good. And I'm actually going to be leaning closer to the higher side on that prediction. Maybe it's even closer to 8 for me as far as what I'm predicting, just because of the lack of inventory. And I really don't see where we're going to get this influx of major inventory over the next 12 months.
Again, to Lane's point, the markets across the country are all different based on their supply and demand and their rising and falling inventories. But in our Southern California, specifically Orange County marketplaces, I would err on the side of a little bit higher there. Again, these predictions are all nationwide. I would say we could be closer to 8%, Lane. What are your thoughts?
For Orange County, I think that's a good prediction for sure.
But let's just dive in really quick on that. What does that mean for sellers and their decisions to sell in the coming year?
It all depends, again, on a bunch of different variables and where they're going. Are they buying down? Are they buying up? Are they moving out of state? Are they staying local? Do they have a growing family? Are they empty nesters? So every situation is going to be a little bit different. But if interest rates are going to be increasing, if home prices are going to be increasing, and you're going to be buying up, you might want to make that move sooner than later.
Correct.
Because it's going to be more expensive when you make that move. If you're buying down, if you don't need to take out a loan, then you might have the flexibility of waiting a little bit more, because that 7% appreciation over the next 12 months, we're not talking over the next month, over the next 12 months, you might be able to stomach that a little bit easier if you wait than if you needed to get a loan.
Exactly. And as we close out this topic, one thing that I've lived my life in, and I like to counsel my clients as well, as really dig deep in your hearts, though, in your minds, and say, what's the timing to move to that next chapter of life? If the marketplace allows you to do that, you don't want to speculate on that last few tens of thousands of dollars by waiting and say, gosh, I could have gotten to X and be enjoying my new lifestyle, whether it's downsizing, upsizing, retiring, what have you. Really dig deep into what you want out of life and then see, does the market fit that story?
Yeah, I think that's really good advice. And I think it's going to be, at least in 2022, when we're talking about prices and we're talking about interest rates and we're talking about buyers versus sellers, I think we're going to finally see buyers and sellers have a little bit of success. So let's get into inventory. I think inventory is going to go up a little bit next year. It has to. It's the lowest it's ever been. It's, we're looking at less than one month supply of inventory, which means, which basically you don't need to know exactly what that means, but it, usually 4 to 6 months is considered neutral. So that means if we quadruple inventory overnight, it's a neutral market. So I think that maybe hopefully inventory doubles and it'll still be 1.8, less than 2 months supply, which is still historically very, very low supply. But good news for the buyers, if they're looking right now, you're going to have a couple more options, twice as many options, hopefully next year than you would. So I do think inventory is going to be going up, and there's going to be a lot of success, hopefully, for both buyers and sellers in 2022.
Right on, Lane. And just for our sellers out there, too, a rise in the inventories does not mean that it suddenly turns into a buyer's market. We've seen only a couple short stints of buyer's markets in my 33-year tenure in this business. So it's a healthy time for sellers and going to look a little bit better for buyers.
No, our marketplace needs inventory, actually. Absolutely. It's like we're having an inventory issue. That's the problem that we're having in the market, in the housing
market.
Okay, so we have interest rates slightly going up.
That's right.
We have prices slightly going up.
Correct.
We have inventory slightly going up. Where do we see demand for 2022? Buyer demand.
Layla, why don't you go ahead and weigh in on this again? You're in the millennial mindset. I mean, you're actually a millennial, and we know so many of our buyers today fit right into the category of where your age is.
Yeah, I think buyer demand is going to be very similar to what it is today. I think it's going to be very consistent because we're going to see more millennials go into the buyer place. What you're going to find out is when inflation goes up and cost of goods go up, you're going to see rent prices go up as well. We're already starting to see it. Rents are getting out of control. So for the millennial population and the population in general that's currently renting right now, they're going to still see historically low interest rates. They're going to see slower moving housing appreciation, and they're going to see fast moving rent increases, which means that they're probably going to get off the fence and probably buy in 2022. So I do think that particular demographic, we're going to see a lot of demand from those buyers. The out-of-state buyers, you know, the ones that are selling and moving out of state, that might slow down a little bit, but it's where we lose that, we're going to make up in a millennial population.
I love it. Let's talk about the baby boomer set for just a moment, because that's kind of where my mindset comes from. And we look at these baby boomers, a lot of them, they do own investment properties. They're selling those investment properties, and they're taking their money, and they're kind of moving it out of state just to get a better rate of return. Those properties are being bought up by the millennials, so we're actually going to see, I believe, the owner occupancy rate rise in a lot of the condos and the small homes in Orange County. Secondly, the baby boomers that are thinking about selling, most of those folks, a decent percentage or a small percentage actually, are buying in the same marketplace, just scaling down to put money in the bank, saying we don't need the 4,000 square foot house anymore. We'll go ahead and buy a condo. We've had several clients that have done that in the past year. Mm-hmm. But we're seeing more and more these folks are saying, you know what, we're ready for a change. We're ready to get out of California and experience life somewhere else. And there's two reasons for that. One is to get closer to family. Or sometimes it's just to try something else, whether they want an adventure lifestyle, they move to some of these places that have a lot of outdoor activities while they're still young. Maybe they want to move to the East Coast. Maybe they want to move to where it's sunny 365 days a year, the deserts or Florida and so forth. So that's what I'm kind of seeing, a little bit of a shift in the baby boomers, is they are more kind of moving out of the area than moving down in the same area.
Which still translate at the end of the day to a stronger demand, I'd say.
Absolutely,
so,
yeah.
So yeah, to recap for our 2022 housing market forecast, interest rates slightly increase, prices slightly increase, inventory slightly increased, demand staying strong.
Absolutely.
So that's what we see for 2022 next year. We can't wait to do more of these videos with you in 2022, and hopefully that you find value, because we're going to be coming with our Real Estate Home Beat every Wednesday.
Yes,
stay
sir.
Tuned for more videos.
Thank you, Lane. Thanks, audience, for watching.